Hello, I'm the Unknown Editor, and today we're going to be ranking all of the Doctor Who title sequences right here. I've been wanting to do this video for quite some time now, and I finally got round to it, especially after you guys said in a community post that this is the kind of content that you would want from this channel. I'm not going to keep you in an intro forever, so yeah, let's get right into the ranking. So, in last place, we have the 2013 titles. Now, before I go on to rank any of these, I just want to say I don't hate any of these title sequences. There are just some that are better than others, if you know what I mean. But this one is... it's just bad. Like the terrible TARDIS model at the beginning with the wooden windows and the... you can just see it's green-screened in and... it hurts my eyes to look at as an editor, but yeah, it's like, where's it even set? There's so much happening. There's so many like nebulas and like planets, and it's like, it's not set anywhere. Like most Doctor Who title sequences are either set in space or the time vortex, but this is just nowhere. It just looks lower budget than the original one from 1963, and it just hurts to look at. The only thing I do like about it is the time vortex, that it's red and it's just a nice time vortex. And the other thing I like about it is the music. I think it's Murray Gold at his absolute best, but everything else is just terrible. I mean, they brought back the face in the title sequence for it, but even that, they've blended it in with one of like the nebulas. And it makes Matt Smith's face look like he has like really curly hair. And when I watched this title sequence as a kid, I thought it was Colin Baker, not Matt Smith. So this is in last place just because I don't hate it, but it's pretty terrible, let's be honest. So this title sequence is very confusing. I don't really get why they did it. It's always sort of like it's just the 2010 titles with an Instagram filter over it, which, I mean, again, I don't hate, but it just feels really pointless. Like, couldn't have they just used the 2010 ones? Like, I get that they wanted to do something different, but if they wanted to do something different, just have the 7B titles instead and have them early and have them all the way through Series 7 instead of having these random, weird titles that are different each episode. Like, I get that that was an idea from the 70s, but they didn't have the budget to do it at the time. But the fact that these titles exist kind of prove the fact that it doesn't, that idea doesn't work to me. Yeah, I just think these titles are just really pointless, so that's why they go so low in the list. And I don't hate them, but they just exist, they're there, and that's that, I suppose. So in 15th place we have the Capaldi era title sequence, which I don't hate. Again, I actually do quite like the sequence in general, but I don't like the music. Like, the main downside to this sequence is the music. It's way too whiny. It sounds like a cat being dragged across the road trying to sing the Doctor Who theme, which Murray Gold may or may not have done. But yeah, and the clock as well. I don't really get it. Like, if clocks were more of a main theme in the Capaldi era, it would have worked more, but they weren't. You know, maybe something like in the Paul McGann era, where his TARDIS has lots of clocks around it, it would have worked more for him. And a lot of the time, the way I judge title sequences is whether it fits the Doctor that it's assigned to or not, and in my opinion, this just doesn't fit Capaldi. and the only time it does fit Capaldi is the rock version of the theme, but that's only for one episode, so I can't really judge it for that. Also, in I think all of the series 9 episodes, the theme is out of sync with the title, so it 100% gets a point down for that. And yeah, I think it's a disappointing title sequence. It looks too animated. The title sequence looks like a Pixar movie. Yeah. Again, I don't hate them, but I definitely don't like them. So, in 14th place, we have the TV movie title sequence, which I do like this title sequence. It's very cinematic, it suits the TV movie, but I just don't think it holds up to the other ones. The main downside to it is the theme. I'm not sure about it. I think John Debney, as the maker of the music for the TV movie, did a really good job, but I think because he's used to doing orchestral stuff, he didn't do the original theme of Doctor Who justice. So yeah, I'm not keen on the theme. And another thing I'm not keen on is the fact that there's kind of too many stars. Like, I get that there's the time vortex there, but there's loads of like stars in the background, and it just kind of makes it look like it's more of a wormhole in space than rather a time vortex, which is what it's supposed to be. And I know space appears in loads of title sequences that I've done, but I just feel like it's way too prominent in this sequence. So, yeah, I do like it, but I think it has quite a few obvious flaws, which is why it's quite low in the list. So in 13th place we have the 1980 titles, which are the original version of the iconic Starfield titles that they used up until 1986. And again, I do like this, but it always felt to me like it was more of a sort of prototype of what to come in the Davison and Baker title sequences. It doesn't really suit Tom Baker. Like, I get that John Nathan Turner was trying to sort of reinvent Doctor Who in the 1980s, which he did do with this title sequence. I think the obvious flaw that everyone seems to hate is the picture they chose to use of Tom Baker. It's a terrible photo of Tom. He looks like he's just seen someone ripped apart to pieces. I don't know why they chose that photo, but they did. It's there. I like the theme. It's a really nice rejig of the theme that Peter Howell did for the 1980s. But I think it could be improved upon massively, which it was in future title sequences, which we'll get to. So in 12th place we have the 1982 Peter Davison titles, which, like I said, are essentially the upgraded later Tom Baker titles. They suit Peter Davison's Doctor a lot better because he was a lot more energetic than the previous ones because he was younger, obviously. And yeah, they're basically just improved on the 1980 titles. I can't really say anything bad about them. Again, the theme stays the same, thank God, because it's a brilliant theme. Peter Howell did so well with rejigging the Delia Derbyshire theme, considering how iconic it was. But yeah, I mean, the one thing I don't like about the Starfield titles is it kind of sort of misses the point of time and, you know, sort of time being incorporated into the title sequence. Whether that's done by using the TARDIS or the Time Vortex or whatever, but yeah, I don't have anything bad to say about these titles, which is why they're sort of in the middle. But yeah, I really like these. So in 11th place we have the 1973 titles, which were for John Pertwee's final season as the Doctor. These are good. I do like these. They're nice to see because they're the prototype of the Tom Baker title sequence, which is interesting because obviously it was more of a test than an actual title sequence, because they were just using the slit scan technology and just sort of figuring out how to use it. So it's not particularly refined, so there are sort of pieces missing of the title sequence. If you watch it, you'll know what I mean. But there's also, I do like the face reveal, the sort of fadey, windy effect that goes around John Pertwee's face as it reveals, obviously, John Pertwee as the Doctor. And then his body turns up as the photo of him sort of goes away from the camera, and you see his whole body, and he's just floating down the time vortex. And it's a very strange effect. It's come to be known as the floating Pertwee of Doom, as I think. It's a bit cringe, it's a bit 1970s, but this title sequence was from an era that was a little bit cringe and a little bit 1970s, quite obviously. So yeah, I like it, it's nice to see, but it's sort of the same case as the final Tom Baker titles. It's something that can be improved upon and is in the future. So, in 10th place, we have the 1966 Patrick Troughton title sequence, which I really do like. I really like this title sequence because I feel like they knew how to use the HoloRound technology sort of more. They were more experienced with it. So it is sort of an upgrade of the William Hartnell title sequence. The only reason this is below the William Hartnell title sequence is just because the Hartnell title sequence is too iconic for me to put in as low a place as this. But I do like this. It looks a little bit weird at the start when the time vortex is sort of forming. It looks more like a sort of building that sort of flows out, which is a little bit weird. But I do like the hiss sound effects, where at the start of the title sequence it almost sounds like the music's or the HoloRound is overflowing. It's a really nice sound effect and it really works well with the title sequence. The photo of Troughton and the reveal of his face has done really well, and I don't really have anything bad to say about this sequence. It's not as good as other ones. So now we come on to the original Doctor Who title sequence as it featured in the first Doctor's era, first appearing in 1963. Now, these are too iconic to put any lower because they are the original, they set the bar from everything else. Nothing like them had been done at the time. The HoloRound effect was, you know, nothing else had been used on it, not to my knowledge anyway. And, It's so iconic that every title sequence has sort of based themselves around it, but put their own take on it slightly. So yeah, there's nothing, obviously it is a bit dated, but in my opinion it does still hold up. There's videos where people, including myself, have tried to sort of modernise it with a few effects but still using the same footage, and I feel like we have achieved that. So yeah, and it does show that it still holds up to all of the other title sequences, maybe not in black and white, but even so, it is iconic, it is the original, and you've got to give it credit for that. So in 8th place, we have the 1970 title sequence, which ran through the majority of the John Pertwee era. So I do love this title sequence. It's very colourful. You can see they made use of the having Doctor Who in colour and being able to film it in colour. And yeah, this is the last time that they used the howl around effect properly. And they have sort of mastered using it, so they make all these vortexes that actually look like vortexes rather than just sort of random mirrory things. And the thing I like about this is it looks alien. It doesn't look like human. It doesn't look CGI. There's no TARDIS. There's no flashy, you know. It looks alien. And the Third Doctor was alien. Obviously, every Doctor's alien, but the Third Doctor, they were very alien, and I think that this title sequence definitely fitted John Pertwee's interpretation of the character, and it suited him, and it's very 70s, obviously, but you know, that's what I love about it. It's a very good title sequence. The logo as well, the way the sort of howl around sort of swirls around the logo and around John Pertwee's face. It's just phenomenal. It's very good for the 1970s or 1969 when it was actually made. But yeah, very nice title sequence and one of my favourites despite being in 8th place because I like a few more than this one. So in 7th place we have the 2018 titles, otherwise known as the Jodie Whisker title sequence, which is a very nice title sequence. I really like the vortex, I really like the music, and I like the fact that it's different. It's a reinvention of the sort of, you can see the inspiration from the McCoy and Troughton title sequences, because the person who did this, Ben Pickles, who was also the guy who did the regeneration effects in the Chibnall era, it's almost as if he sort of looked at the original title sequences and went, how can I modernise this? And he came up with this title sequence, which I think is really good. The one thing that I don't like about it is that it doesn't fit the visuals that are seen in the series, so I'll probably put this on the screen now, but in the in a lot of the episodes of the Whisker era, there are VFX shots of the TARDIS in the Time Vortex that we just see throughout the episode when the TARDIS is flying through time, and the vortex there looks more like a dark tunnel and doesn't really look much like the actual title sequence vortex that we always see at the beginning of the episode, which has always kind of bugged me, but again, it doesn't really take away from the title sequence. But yeah, I also like that he chose to, well, maybe the BBC chose to, but the title sequence changes a little bit between series 12 and series 13, and in Revolution of the Daleks, the title sequence becomes more colourful. There's a lot more sort of vibrant colours that you can see in the sequence, which I do like, and that's the version that I'm showing on screen right now rather than the original, which I think is a little bit too dark, but either way, I like the title sequence. It's a modern classic because obviously it's the Howl Around sequence but modernised and made a lot more sort of to work in this day. And I really like that about it, so yeah. But I do like others more, which is why it's in 7th place. So in 6th place, we have the Christopher Eccleston / Early Tennant titles, which you can't not give credit. They did exactly what they needed to. The show was back on air in 2005, had been revived by Ross T Davies, and yeah, it is the Doctor Who title sequence. It's probably the one that's most nostalgic to me personally, but yeah, it did exactly what it was supposed to, and yeah, this, by the way, this ranking of the 2005 titles also includes the Early Tennant titles, just because it's basically the same title sequence but just with a slightly different colour scheme, and with David Tennant's name instead of Christopher Eccleston. But yeah, the music done by obviously Murray Gold, who did an outstanding job with putting breathing life into the old Derbyshire theme, which of course is timeless, but he made it more modern. The one thing that I don't like about this title sequence, is the way it was carried. I can understand that when Tennant became the Doctor, Chris had only had one series, and they just thought, well, we just might as well just reuse the title sequence. But in my opinion, with a new Doctor, most of the time you're going to need a new title sequence, which they kind of did in the late Tennant years with the Series 4 theme and the new TARDIS model and all of that lovely stuff. Again, it did what it was supposed to. I can't really blame them for not making a new one for Tennant because of the budget that Doctor Who had at the time, which was fairly small compared to what it has these days, especially with Disney involved with Doctor Who now. Did exactly what it needed to, and just is a Doctor Who title sequence, which is what the show needed at the time, and you can't not give it credit for that. So in fifth place we have the 2010 main Matt Smith titles, which are another of the nostalgic titles for me, believe it or not. I really like these. It's kind of an upgrade of the David Tennant one, so it kind of sort of carries on what that title sequence introduced in the modern version of Doctor Who, and sort of did its own thing with it, made it more gothic, and it's just really good. It's quite cinematic, and it really gets across the sort of dark fairy tale theme that Stephen Moffat was going for in Series 5. It does have some downsides, though. I don't really understand why in Series 6 they just kept it. Like, don't get me wrong, I love this title sequence, but I always sort of assumed that the lightning cracks were to resemble the crack in time from Series 5, and that obviously gets resolved at the end of Series 5, so the fact that that's not sort of like taken out for the Series 6 title sequence, I don't really know. And because time is sort of falling apart in Series 5, I also think that's probably why they chose to use a storm vortex, and I think it's a little bit lazy, the fact that they didn't change it, or maybe they could have had the fire vortex for the entire thing. I don't know, I'm just spitballing here. But overall, it's really good. It is a bit underused. I feel like they should have just used this for all of Matt Smith's era. I get that they wanted to do something different for the 50th anniversary year in 2013, but we all saw how that turned out. But yeah, I love these. They're underused and, in my opinion, quite underrated. So in fourth place we have the 1974 title sequence, which is just iconic. It suits Tom Baker's Doctor. It's obviously iconic. It's the one that everyone remembers and goes, that's Doctor Who. And it's the first title sequence which doesn't use the slit scan effect, which is quite brave of the BBC at the time, considering how iconic that look was for Doctor at the time. And yet the title sequence just reinvents itself, and yeah, it's just an amazing sequence. It's very colourful, and it upgrades on what the sort of later Pertwee titles did. And yeah, I don't have anything bad to say about it, because there is nothing bad to say about it. It's just not my absolute favourite, but you got to give it credit for being the Doctor Who title sequence that everything else is sort of loosely based on. So in third place we have the 2008 later David Tennant titles, which I really do like. It turns out that a lot of the better title sequences here are upgrades of a sort of prototype that came before. And in this case, the prototype is the original Series 1 Christopher Eccleston title sequence, which then carried on into David Tennant in Series 2 and Series 3. And then in Series 4, we get a bit of an upgrade on the title sequence, which has like a different TARDIS model, and it's got different music, which suits the actual sequence better and is much more suited to David Tennant's version of the Doctor. But I think, you know, this version of the title sequence is the final upgrade for the RTD1 titles, which are all sort of vaguely the same, but this is just the one that is upgraded the most and is probably the most iconic to David Tennant's Doctor. And I was complaining in the 2005 title sequence when I ranked it, saying it was a shame that they just used the same title sequence for David Tennant. They just changed the name from Christopher Eccleston to David Tennant in the titles and then just left it. Which is here what they've opted to improve on, with having different music, sort of a different colour for the Vortex, and making it more sort of suited to, again, David Tennant's interpretation of the Doctor. And I really like that about it. It's iconic. There's literally nothing bad you can say about it, and yeah, that's why it's in third place. And in second place we have the 1986 title sequence, which used to be my favourite, but now it's in second place just because I've grown to like another one just a tiny bit more. But this one I absolutely adore, simply because it suits the Sixth Doctor. And I know that may sound stupid, but it's colourful. Colin Baker was a very colourful Doctor, and it utilises the Peter Davison title sequence and changes it into something that fits Colin Baker's Doctor, and I just absolutely love that about it. The music is such a bop, honestly, like I could dance to it forever, not going to, but yeah. And I'm pretty sure that Dominic Glynn, who was the guy who did the music for this title sequence, only had like 2 weeks to make it, and you gotta give him credit for that, because the BBC obviously didn't treat him very well, but he came up with this score, this modern iteration of the Howl and Derbyshire title sequence, sort of put together to create a theme that's very sort of unique and suits Colin Baker's Doctor. I do think it's a shame how massively underused this title sequence is, because it was only in Doctor Who for one series, but yeah, it's one of the best title sequences which has ever been done, in my opinion. But overall, suits Colin Baker's Doctor, the music is absolutely amazing, and it's underused, and in my opinion, criminally underrated. So, in first place, we have the 1987 Sylvester McCoy title sequence. Now, before you start ranting in the comments going, "Oh, you're wrong, it looks awful," you have to understand, it is the most ambitious title sequence of all of them. It's the first CGI title sequence. It uses a theme tune which is completely different to the original Derbyshire theme, or the Howl theme, or the Glynn theme. And it really did something that nobody expected it to, and wasn't afraid to do something different. Now, it's all very well saying, oh, it did all of this stuff. Did it do it well for 1987 and for a budget TV show? Yes, absolutely. I think on some days, apparently, like, one frame of the title sequence would take days, like a day to render, which, I mean, I render all my edits in about 1 minute, so considering that this took days, weeks to render is just so commendable, and the effort that they put into this title sequence is simply amazing. And I also think it's genius because it suits Sylvester McCoy's Doctor so well. It's got the nebula that represents like space, and the music is just so, it's so sort of like alien and almost childish in a way, which McCoy's Doctor was at the start of his era, but it's also got that mysterious tone to it, which again McCoy's Doctor also had. And yeah, I just absolutely love it. I think it's genius, it suits McCoy, and it is incredible, and I'm not sure we're ever going to get a title sequence better than this. I know it looks very 80s and the CGI isn't very good, but I appreciate it for what it is. And if you look at the concept of Nebula and the TARDIS with the sort of space bubble around it and McCoy's face and the logo, you're just going to think, well, if we add today's CGI and remade that, which some people have actually done, it would be absolutely amazing. So I look at it from that point of view and say, this is my favourite title sequence. Not because of the CGI, but because of the concept and the way that it was executed. So yeah, I absolutely love it, and I don't think we're ever going to get anything better than this. So that concludes this video. I want to thank you for sticking around. If you've gotten to the end of this video, please get help. But also, thanks for sticking around the channel lately. My channel's been blowing up, been getting so many views, especially on that Shooting Apple video that's gotten 60,000 views now, which is just unreal. So I want to thank you guys for that, and thank you guys for checking out this video. I'll see you in the next one. If you like these ranking videos, do tell me, and if you disagree with my very controversial opinions, please tell me in the comments, but try not to rant. Goodbye.